submarine still smells like shit, even outside the walls.
We'll find Croft here, somewhere.
Yeah.
You alright?
Never better. Back under the Mad King, they used to say death by sword was a sweet kiss. But fire would fuck you hard.
Funny.
No. No, not very.
I'll go find Croft's tent.
Asher, I need you to tell me the truth. I've come a long way to bring you home. Back in that cave, you made a choice. You must have thought only one of us was going to survive. Now, it's not a fair question to ask, but I need to know.
I've been fighting side by side with Beskar for 4 years. She has saved my life more times than I care to admit. I owe her.
Thank you for being honest. But she's not family. Look, I can't blame you if your feelings about me are conflicted. Or your feelings about going home. Your family exiled you to this place. But I swore an oath to your mother, sailed halfway around the world to bring you back safe. And I'd be damned if some dragonfire or your foul decisions are gonna stop me. Are we clear? I'm here to help you.
I'm sorry, Malcolm. I did you wrong.
Well, it's good of you to say so. But words are wind, Asher. It's choices that define who you are.
Asher, I know where Croft is.
This Croft, how well do you know him?
Too well.
I thought you said you were friends.
Yeah, we are. We are. Great friends.
Asher fucking Forrester! Son of a poxy whore! You have some balls walking into my tent after all these years with that mama's monkey grin on your face.
Well, that went well.
All right, maybe I deserve that.
That's not even a taste of what you deserve. You never understood consequences, Asher. One stupid mistake cost me an eye. But you never learn. You figured you'd steal from me and I'd just forgive you? Not a fucking chance! So how are you going to pay me back? Your eye? Your hand? Or how about your tongue?
Croft, no!
Be reasonable!
I am reasonable! I'm letting him fucking choose!
Look, Croft, what we did was wrong. I'm sorry for that.
You heard him, now let him go!
You're not getting out of this with a fucking apology!
Croft, I deserve your anger as much as Asher.
Don't worry, Beskar. You're next. Now choose, or I slice off your balls, Asher.
A man
betrays my trust.
You fucking bastard. Take my eye, then. I don't need two to kill you.
Done.
Oh, that was bloody beautiful. Fucking Asher. You were pale as a snow bear's ass!
Are you fucking joking? You bloody bastard.
This is why people steal your shit and take off in the night.
Come on, you assholes. Have a drink.
Jodan, the Khaleesi's best wine.
Your friend has an interesting sense of humor.
So what in seven hells are you two doing here on the arse end of the earth, eh?
You're a long way from, young guy.
We have a proposition for you.
We? You're hardly the usual rabble these two travel with.
Your sword was always the quickest, Croft. I need you and your men to fight for me in Westeros.
We need your hellhounds. 100 good men.
Am I in a hobby's tip? Would I ever go back to Westeros?
I've got it good right here. Her Grace pays good coin.
I've got wine! Women!
We can pay.
I always knew your pockets were lined with gold. And I will happily take it from you. But it's not up to me. The Second Sons are sworn to Daenerys Targaryen. I've laid my sword at her feet. For now.
Perhaps we could talk to her.
She's a little busy right now, commanding a fucking siege. Her enemies are nailing children up on posts for 100 miles, and a bloody dragon's gone missing.
But I know where to find her dragon.
Ha! Unfucking likely. You expect me to believe you just happened to have seen the one fucking dragon loose in the world?
Orange eyes, as big as my head. Scales all black.
That doesn't prove anything. Enough of this nonsense.
I've got proof, you old fuck. Tell me what this is, if not a bloody dragon tooth.
I wouldn't know a dragon tooth from a basilisk dick.
Croft, I've seen her dragon.
Oh, bugger me with a bloody spear. If you're lying about this...
Fair enough.
Come on, you son of a bitch. The beast's name is Drogon. She'll want to hear about him right away. And don't think you're going to charm her with that fucking Asher grin.
Day tomorrow, isn't it? Off to Craster's Keep. Assuming you're not too busy looking for your North Grove.
I thought you didn't believe in it.
Not saying I do. But if it was real, can you trust Potter with it? Ask me. There's just something off about him. Aside from him being an oily thief, I mean. Like he's holding something back.
Potter's not a bad sort. I trust him.
Even after he tried stealing your map? Do as you like. But if we're going out there tomorrow, in the middle of fucking nowhere, I'd want to know who I can trust.
Finn, get back on watch until your relief arrives.
They're late!
You think Mance Rayder is going to wait for them?
Right!
Asshole.
And Tuttle, you've got torches that have gone out. Keep them lit. Let the wildlings know we're still home.
That's ironwood for sure. If anyone tries coming over the wall, well, those will stop them. Be here soon. Wonder who's riding it.
Pig farmer. A 300-mile walk, and you're still in my way.
I figured we'd settle things on the way to Craster's, but this is even better.
Oh, fuck you, Brit. Still have some fighting spirit left in you, huh?
I did duty to my lord back on that bloody farm. And for doing a proper job of it, what'd I get? Banished to the fucking wall!
Never did tell you about your father, did I? We bled him at first, like a pig. Seemed only fair he should feel what it's like. Near the end, he could barely breathe. Kept begging us to leave your sister alone, so I made sure he was still alive when she started screaming. It was the last thing your father ever heard. The more we sliced, the worse it got.
You're not worth it.
I didn't come here to chat, you fucking cunt! Too bad your father didn't fight like that. Might still be alive. And I thought you were going to make this easy.
Stop, dammit! I don't want to fight you!
What's the matter? Don't you want to make your father proud? Let's see if you scream like your sister.
You got lucky, pig farmer. You're going to slaughter me, like my man back at your farm. At least let me have my sword. Keep it interesting. Or are you afraid?
I swore my vows. I won't kill a brother.
You're fucking pathetic, Tuttle. Finish it! Go on.
That's not a mercy you deserve.
My lord, our people are starving and afraid. The White Hills have driven them away from the ironwood groves.
Out of the way!
And so they come to us, looking for food. Food we don't have to spare. How can we support an army and retain our position in the north? We can't even feed the people we see before us. It's like the dead of winter's come. And it doesn't look like it's getting better.
These are hard times, to be sure. Harder than I've ever seen. But I'll do whatever it takes to get us through it.
Well, I hope we can figure something out. As long as the White Hills are in our house, we have to be careful.
Come on, you!
Let me go! You can't do this!
Good. You're here. Look. Look at this! Did you see what this girl did? She attacked my man like an animal!
Bloody bit me!
Yeah, now it's her turn! She's gonna get what she has coming to her. This won't go unpunished.
Let go of me!
I don't care if she's your sister.
He deserved it.
Fine. You brought her to me. I'll deal with her.
That's not for you to decide.
I saw him stealing from our kitchen, and I told him to stop. He laid his hands on me, so I bit him.
Bloody wench!
I was only doing what had to be done.
I warned you not to mistreat my men. Someone will have to answer for this.
Do you hear me?
Don't make this ugly.
Thieves have to be punished, so your man got what he deserved. He's lucky he didn't get any worse than that.
So you've given over your duties to this girl, then? Or can you not control your sister?
Don't listen to him, Roderick.
And if you can't rein her in, what about the rest of them? It's about time she saw a real lord again and learned proper discipline. They've all been missing that. So now this house has gone to rot. And the problem starts at the top, Roderick.
Careful, boy.
You yourself had the gall to strike one of my men. And that's the real problem with you foresters. You're too fucking proud. Always have been. It was bad enough when you were above us. And now it's even worse. Because you don't see how far you've fallen.
Still high enough to look down at you.
Wait. Forgive her. Forgive her. The passions of youth. No one questions your authority, Griff. You have the power.
Oh, I like him. You thought this was your man, Roderick? He's mine. A dog to be sure, but my dog.
That's how I like to see you, foresters.
Obedient servants!
He's a loyal member of my house. A man of peace. And he deserves to be treated as such.
You don't get it, do you? You foresters need to learn when you're beaten.
You will learn some fucking humility.
Oh, this won't be the last lesson I teach you foresters!
Have you no honor? I'll run you through for that. I'll cut you down like straw men.
I'm fine, Roiland. I'm fine. I'll handle this.
Even broken, he's twice the man you are.
I bet this makes you angry, eh? You probably want to get up and hit me. But we know how that would go, don't we? Now, are you going to be a good little forester, learn your lesson, and stay down?
Roderick!
I said, get down! All the way down.
Get up, Roderick!
Stay down, my lord.
Your brother defied Ramsay Snow. He didn't know his place, but we made damn sure he learned. I'll probably have to teach Talia here. Unless you're a good little forester. You learn your place. And stay down.
Some forester is gonna learn their lesson today.
You don't have to do that, Lord Griff.
Don't you dare! You stay down! Stay in the mud, like a dog!
This is my place!
You fool!
My lord!
What?! Bloody cripple! Are you fucking deaf?!
You! You'll never keep the foresters down!
Hold there, or you're next!
Please, Lord Griff, help the arm! If you persist, Lord Roderick may lose it!
Now, stay down!
Tell me!
Will you be a good little forester? You can't.
I command you!
Let him alone!
I'll do as I like! You should fear me! I'm in charge here!
Have you had enough, Griff? Are we done here?
Don't think this is over, Roderick! You'll see! I will make you suffer for this! Trust in that!
My boy.
Careful. He's badly injured.
Roderick! You didn't let him do it! He couldn't keep you down!
You were brave. But there will be consequences, my son. We both know that.
Do you see that? Standing up to Griff has made him harsh. More severe. He could have killed you. But what you did, the strength you showed us. You looked like yourself again. It was good to see.
I couldn't just stand by and let Griff punish you. Damn the consequences. And I'd do it again. 1,000 times.
I know you would. And when you're better, things will be different. I asked Ethan not to change who he was. He promised he wouldn't, and look what happened. I now know that was childish of me. I'm ready to change now. I'm willing to do anything to help our family. I mean it, Roderick. I don't care what. I'll do it.
You don't have to do that. It's up to me to protect the house.
This is my house too. I have to do something. And I'm sure the others will do whatever it takes as well. What you did, provoking Griff, it hasn't taken our house to war just yet. But...
No one can know the future. Whatever tomorrow brings, Talia, foresters will stand tall.
I did it. I can't believe it. What are you waiting for?
There's no good that can come from this. Not anymore.
The Khaleesi will see you now.
So, Asher Forrester, if you presume to speak of my dragons, choose your words carefully.